Hello, everybody. This is Stephen Sykes, Mr. LP, and I'm here with my lovely grandma, as promised. Aaron Fane, the beautiful, wonderful, can I say your whole name? Mm-hmm. Naomi Harris, for Nae Young. And I will tell you a little bit about yourself, Grandma. You were born in Georgia.
Yeah, Louisville, Georgia.
Louisville for Savannah.
Oh, Bartow. Yeah, really Bartow. A little place that on the map. You can hardly see it.
Bartow?
Yeah.
Okay, B-A-R-T-O. Okay, so we go to... And you was on the reservation where they only came once a month?
Who, Mommy?
You know, when you were born, they come once a month to... You told me how they used to come once a month to just gather everybody who was born that month.
Oh, yeah. But, we had a whole lot of them. Plus, we went to school, and I could read when I was 6 years old. Mm. That's when we went to school.
They allowed you to read?
I could read before I was 6 years old. I helped my sister with my homework.
Oh, my.
Aunt Lily.
Oh, Aunt Lily? We, yesterday we were talking about, a lot of my friends are going through, unfortunately, and family, and just a lot of people out there in the world going through so much domestic violence,
yeah.
You know, men beating on women, but you never took that.
Nope, I'm not taking a beating for anything. No, no, you keep your hands off of me, because I'm going to hit back.
You're pretty mean with a bat.
Bad in my fist too.
tell me a story of what would you do to a guy who beat you, who would try to beat you?
Well, I'd beat him back. I would scratch his face up, hit him with a bat, a chair, anything I got my hand on. Mm.
You were saying that one time, if you try to do something, you said you beat him with a bat.
Yeah. He said that he came home drunk. My husband was in the service.
Okay.
He came home. I hadn't seen him in 3 months or so. He came home and told me, I get set, Naomi, I'm going inside your head. Mm. I hit him with a bat.
That was the end of that one.
Yeah, and then I dragged him, put him on the bed, and tied him up and beat him up.
What would you say to some of these women that feel like they identify? One thing you have learned... You told me never identify myself with a man. You tell another woman and never let a woman identify herself with me as a man.
What do you mean? I said married women.
Right. But you say never be so into the person you lose themselves.
No. Don't. You can love healthier love. What I mean, you love, you take care of them. And she's a helpmate, not a slave.
But nowadays, a lot of women are calling the shots and taking the control.
Oh, yeah, but see, that's not right. No matter how big they are, men are still going to be the head of the women. Okay.
But they both need to communicate.
Yes. Well, you should have if you're going to have a wife, you should have a... She's to help me. She's to help you.
I understand. What was I like as a kid? I tell them all these stories, and they never believe me.
And well, you were a good little baby. You are about the age of 3 and 2. You was walking, and you would talk, and you tell me what you want. You wanted Cheerios, which you call Oreos. I don't want your little steak and a grits. I want Oreos. Okay, Stephen. One day I didn't have any, so you said, I ain't gonna eat it. I don't want no cornflakes, I'm not gonna eat that. So, well, why not? It's good for you. No, it's not. Oreos are only good for you. Okay? I tell you what, you sit right in that chair and don't move, and I'll be right back. So I had to go run down, about a half a block and get you a box of Cheerios.
Well, I couldn't have to like Cheerios back then.
Do you still like
Cheerios? I still like Cheerios. I don't eat it with the milk still, but every once in a while.
You ate them both ways.
For some reason, I can't do it with the milk these days. If I eat it, I like oatmeal.
You eat them one by one. You take them one by one.
Well, you told me to take my time.
Whoa, you throw the spoon down, they don't want no. So, well, you enjoy them as long as you hate them.
I understand. I used to give the mailman a hard time.
Yeah, well, the mailman bring a letter. And he goes, see, we had a big old husky.
Okay.
Alaska husky. He used to take, get the mail from the mailman. So someone, the one came that didn't know him, and he frayed something in his nose and he died. Mm. So after that, he used to say, you get the mail. Go there and tell him, give me the mail. Where's the mail? He said, well, you don't have it today, Stephen. I said, well, yes, you do. You got to give me something.
Well, I remember the, I gave the mailman a hard time because it was late. He was always late.
Yeah, that's what he said, late. He said, well, Stephen, I'm just substituting for the real mailman. He's on a little vacation. So, well, you're supposed to be here the same time he does.
Tell them the story about the kid that tried to beat me.
Oh, every day... Before, after breakfast, you would go out there and sit on a little cement barge, like a little cement barge around there. And have a little, you could take cushions out and sit, but you just sat there and cross your little leg. You had on a little blue shorts and a little white t-shirt. And then this little boy came and told him, I'll beat you up. And you say nothing. He hit you in the nose. You got to come out there one day. And you were a little leg crossed, and you had two tears. So what's wrong, Stephen? Said the boy, beat me up. But why did you hit him back? He said, no, you told me not to fight. No, I didn't tell you not to do that. I told you that don't start a fight. So I said, nah, you don't let him fight you no more. And when he comes to fight you, you fight him back. So I went in the house. The next day I come back, I heard a lot of noise. I came outside to see what happened. You had threw him down and you was beating him up.
I thought I was going to kill that boy.
You was really beating him. Everybody had come out of the house laughing because he had been doing this for 2 years.
He was older.
Michelle was out there and then he wouldn't bother.
Yes, my cousin Michelle beat, but my cousin Michelle would fight everybody for me.
Yeah, she did. You didn't pick on her, Stephen. It was so funny. It was like a holiday. I was home because I'd come home that morning. I'd put your pool on the patio. Mm-hmm. We lived on the second floor. I filled it full of water. So Michelle came in. So Michelle said, where's Stephen? I said, he's out there in the pool. Stephen, so Michelle didn't have a bathing suit. I went out there and Michelle and you in the pool. Buckley, you got your shorts on. Michelle don't have on a thing. Oh, no. Michelle.
Lady's hot.
Lady not supposed to bathe. It was not a bathing suit. Well, I didn't have a bathing suit. That's okay. I'll call your mother. She'll bring you one.
Oh, boy.
So she goes out. She puts on the bathing suit. You end up playing in the water. And tell her you got tired. You came in and I gave you some chicken, fried chicken. And I told Michelle, well, she said, Grandma, can I have another pizza? I said, yeah. And I had the dough going, boom, 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 boom. She went and got all the brothers and came. And when I went to get a pizza and fix our dinner, we didn't have any chicken. When I was on the crumbs there.
Everybody ate all the chicken.
Yeah, you know, I should have went when I heard the dough going, boom, boom. And I opened the door and go out, boom, boom.
Everybody ate chicken.
And so you had a jet. Mm-hmm. It was a red wheels and yellow.
Well, it was just red, but it was red and yellow?
Yeah, I see the wood was like that.
Okay. Know?
And but the wheels were painted red inside. Mm-hmm. So you love to play with that jet around and around the house. So we got, I say, well, they got the new car now, so power one run by battery, get him one of those. So Nessa say, yeah, let's get him a power car. So you got a power car. Oh boy, you thought you couldn't drive that thing. Round and round the living room when it went. You had a big living room, like big as all of this, and went all around. All around down the hall in the bedroom. told you, I said, well, let's take him outside. Maybe he'll be all right. He said, yeah, let's, but Stephen, don't you play on that side near the dumpster, because that's where the cars come in at.
Right.
So, oh, okay, Stephen playing out there. So we're going to go look for him, because he's been out a long time, and the battery run down on that thing. I come, you're pushing four boys in the Jeep. And you're pushing, they all riding in the Jeep. I said, that's even for you.
Why was I always so helpful?
I don't know. I think you just like to get along with people. You like to, everybody to like you. And well, I told you, Stephen, if they don't like you, who cares? So, look, you don't have to buy friendship.
No.
You tell me, well, they wanted, it just didn't move. I'd have got on if it started, but I said the battery ran down. You still brought it home in the house.
One of the things I tell everybody, Grandma, is I was blessed enough to raised by you initially in the beginning, because a lot and had you around. A lot of kids don't have their grandparents, and kids are just so bad these days.
Oh, yeah. Oh, gee whiz. I got an old album. I'll show you if you want to.
Okay,
a few
sure.
Pictures.
We'll get the album. You don't have.
It's in my room. I had it because my son, I think my son and I was going taking pictures of it. I'm not for sure.
Okay.
So, but I haven't even hit it.
Grandma, mm-hmm. You don't have to.
Alright? I'm going
to hop. Do I dare tell her no? I never been beat, but I do not want to be the first. She may be 82, but I will get the worst beating in my life. So I just have to tell her, just let it go. And she knows I'm recording, but she just what can you do? Grandma, are you okay? She is extremely feisty, if you can't tell. And she knows, I'm just walked off. But here, I'm here for Thanksgiving down here in Axton, which is a small little township outside of Martinsville, Henry County. Technically, just literally almost right across the street. It will be the actual city part of Martinsville, I guess. Here she comes. Your grandma?
This one here, you're gonna get a kick out. This one's old and it's raggedy.
Oh boy. I was laughing because I said, this is fun because we're recording all of this. And it's a scene. I said, I don't dare tell you no.
Tell Grandma not always.
I don't tell Grandma no. Oh my, this is fun.
There's a lot of history here. These are some of the, people.
Oh boy.
These are papers that some of the church people had when he got the all different things. So I should have told him to let your song move. There's so much junk in there.
I see you kept a lot of everything of Obama.
I did. I like Obama. I did. Mm-hmm. You didn't. I'm sorry you don't like him.
All right.
Well, I used to go to a lot of concerts of Blind Boys.
Oh, the original five Blind Boys of...
Yeah.
Oh my, this photo is old. This is awesome photo.
Yeah, I used to go to all of them. Me and Roy.
Mm-hmm.
We used to have a lot of fun.
Soul Position. So this is, I'm sorry, Soul Potion Records.
Yeah. Oh.
Wait a second, how you had to block? This is a gospel group, but Soul Potion.
That was good. You know, I had to pay almost $50 for that photo.
$50 for a photo?
Yeah.
Back then, nobody had $50.
He let me have it.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, it's good.
Did you have to kiss him to get that photo?
No.
I have to ask, Grandma.
I have some other. I can't remember the name. It was a women group was there that night. And I don't know. That's just the Albert.
These are just a bunch of nice things.
Yeah, things I kept.
What are some things people can do, Grandma, with these kids these days? Because, you know, people have to work so hard.
You're going to have to do this. You're going to have to start the kid off to Sunday school. You can't stay home and do what he want to do, sleep. You're going to have to start off taking him to Sunday school. And that, they are not going to, they will not. They'll be good kids.
Mm-hmm. That is true.
This is Alberta and Ernesto.
This is our Aunt Alberta?
Yeah, Alberta's on there with the jeans in there.
Oh, my. The one here on the left, right? If anybody don't know, this is my lovely Aunt Alberta. Unfortunately, she's not with us anymore at this time.
No, she's deceased.
And passed away, but she was lovely and wonderful.
Very good.
This is a picture in the on the left hand side, styling and profiling.
She used to take care of me.
Yes, her took care of me and did very well.
Yes, because I had to go to work.
You should not tell people. But I tell people all the time, you was a nurse back then, doing all the stuff long before people had the nursing licenses.
Oh yeah, my goodness.
You worked in the ER.
Yeah, I worked in the ER. I was a nurse's assistant at St. Francis.
St. Francis Hospital, and then also Mercy.
No, I got to be a CDS technician there. This is where you give the doctor everything you need.
See, that's the thing. It's just I know.
They had a job waiting for me when I got here. I should have took it.
Well, Grandma, you retired. Oh my! You got retired though by then.
Yeah, I retired from there at the age of 61.
Right. The funny thing about it, Grandma, is just that I just find it, you know, I know this is how it was, but you did all the nursing and medical phase long before they had all this training. You worked
You
did surgery. Yeah. I
remember when they paid us $45 every 2 weeks.
$45 every 2 weeks. And you were in an ER. You rode in an ambulance van.
No, I didn't. I stayed stationed.
Okay, you stayed at the station, but you got the people off the ambulance van.
Oh yeah.
And then you between surgery, then you did patient care.
Yeah.
All of this without no medical school.
Yeah, I did all of those instrument and everything. I even did anesthesia.
He
just came and told me that. Well, I need you, and you got to learn how to do this. And he showed me. He said, "Now I want you to do it right."
Now you want to do it right? Did anybody not wake up, Grandma?
They all woke up fine, but I was really scared.
Well, it's just amazing. There's people who go to school, med school for 4 or 5, 8 years.
Yeah, and they just told us we had to go in there and go to work.
Oh, boy, my cousins are beautiful, as you can see.
He got so many cousins. Well,
it's about 18, 19 of us.
You know, that's Lillian and Joe.
Right.
Joe's deceased.
Yes, indeed. Put this one in here, Grandma.
You can if you want. Right. That's Michelle right there.
Yeah, in the middle, I think. Yes.
And this.
She's going to kill me, Michelle. I know you're going to get mad when you see this.
And this is Jerome's family.
Yes. Uncle Jerome.
And this is good. We took a picture together.
That's
Rosalind. I wanted to have it done in a big poetry.
That can be done, Grandma.
Yeah.
Modern technology has done a lot of things.
Oh, yeah. That's what I told the guy who took my picture. It just gave him $10 a picture, you know?
No.
I told him, I don't want that.
You want the big poetry?
He said, I want a portrait of mine. He said, I'm going to have to charge you for it. I said, well, I don't expect you to give it to me.
I know y'all may not be able to see, but this was my Rosalind, my mother, Velma Jean. Aunt Alberta and Vanessa. How'd you go with Velma Jean, by the way?
Well, see, my husband said he was going to name my beautiful baby.
Mm-hmm.
She was so beautiful and fat, black hair, and big black eyes. Her eyelashes curled. It was so long. And he told me to my I'm going to name her Minnie. I said, you got to be kidding.
So my mom's name was supposed to be Minnie at first.
Yeah. Oh, that's boy. That's not
Michelle. Oh, yes. People don't realize when me and Michelle, when I was little, me and Michelle were close and we grew up and things, and then she moved to Chicago.
Yeah.
And everything around Alberta and everybody. But this was her
graduation.
Prom
photo. Her
prom. This was
Will you leave I bought her gown?
Oh my. Yeah, this was her senior prom, 18, and things of that nature. Michelle, I keep telling her she needs to work with me and my cousin.
That is your mother graduate from nurses.
Oh, geez. Seton Hall University.
Yeah.
These funny hacks.
Well, they ain't funny no more. They're ain't nice. Every school has their own.
Now, all the different things, Grandma, out there, why did you decide to be a nurse tech?
Oh, well, I just wanted a job. I didn't know I was going into that.
What would you, if you weren't a nurse all those years, what would you do?
Oh, I was going to nursing school. Okay. I got married instead.
Well, one of the things that you did that I tell everybody that, and some do, some don't, but you went back to school.
Oh, yeah. I didn't finish my 11th grade.
Right.
But when I went back, I took the 11th grade over because if you do the 11th grade, I take care of the 12th.
Yeah, because you went to Day, if I remember, you went both. When I was born, you were 44.
Yeah.
But you finished before you were 48. Yeah. But you went to Day and night class. That's the reason why.
Yeah. I got off from work and I had to be to work at 6. I got off from work at 5:30 and I had to be to work at 6:30. And I had to go home and cook supper.
You got off at 5:30, you worked supper, and then I remember either Rosalind or my brother watched me while you went back to school.
Yeah.
For night school.
Well, they all was there. They just was over the house somewhere.
So yeah, I just left me there.
Yeah. I think this is Macy.
Whose dog was this?
Their dog.
I don't remember the dog.
And that's Grandma, you know. He's getting ready to go to church at this communion, for this communion Sunday.
Well, this is your mother.
Yeah.
Say her whole name for me.
Mary Lee Young.
Mary Lee Young. And she was, you are one of 14, how many of you?
Oh, she had 8 of us, 4 girls and 4 boys.
How far was born? She's like 13.
Well, she lost 2.
Okay, I'm sorry. But yeah, there's that many. And then your father, Mike.
I think that's Lily's daughter there.
And your father, which will be my great-grandfather, was the head of a church in New Jersey, in Trenton.
Oh, yeah. He was a pastor of Beauty Grove Primitive Baptist Church.
Okay.
When I came in, you know, I was Primitive Baptist.
What was it? Beauty Grove?
Mm-hmm.
Beauty Grove Permanent Baptist Church.
Mm-hmm.
That's an interesting name.
Well, now, the pastor who married us, and my daughter surprised because she said she thought I was married. I told her, what? My mother and daddy took me to the
classroom. Yeah, well, y'all were married.
Yes, she was. My mother and dad signed for, you know, witness on the license. So she was saying, I thought you. I said, yes, sir. She just held her eyes and she took it.
Oh, boy. This was the first, I think I mailed this to you when I was.
Yeah, she did.
My first honor roll when we went to, I first went to Law Park. This was the first honor roll.
Yeah, you mailed it to me.
I remember mailing this to you, first honor roll. From eighth. We were in eighth grade. Well, no, this was eighth or ninth grade. We were there at eighth grade, but we were there at eighth grade. We got the honor roll and stuff like that.
So. And that is. We got that's Michelle right there. That's in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, that's your daddy in there. Hey, y'all was cute. Mm-hmm. I don't know who that baby is.
I don't remember.
Oh, my God. Oh, that's some of the DCs. I got a lot of them. That was one of the guys at the church here.
Understand.
Yeah, I thought that. I think I have just done. I think I have just done too.
Oh no! Yes, I don't believe. I though, Grandma, don't do this one.
Now, come on.
Don't do this
one. You sent it to me.
I know I sent it to you, but I said this was one. I said I really. Oh gosh, I hate the glasses.
yeah, but you need glasses now. Why don't you wear
them? I'll get some more, Grandma. I just needed to.
Well, they got the one that you can go buy. You know.
This was some of us were allowed to help out with the prom, the 10th grade year. And then so they took pictures. I was very grateful. I don't know if it's about 10 of us. I don't remember all who were there, but we were allowed to take some pictures, so I did it. So I'm gonna post this one because I know people gonna laugh at this one.
This is Joshua here. He didn't have too much good faith. I don't know where Joshua is. He told me that he's in prison.
Somewhere. But this was the early ATV.
Hey, I remember your what they call that wheel?
Three wheelers.
Remember I bought you one.
Yeah, these were these three wheelers and things back then.
Remember I bought you one.
Yes, I love that thing. I was sad when that thing died.
Yeah, it was noisy enough.
Yeah, it was noisy. I'm gonna figure out why this one won't work with the light. I don't know why.
Well,
it'll come.
It should.
Okay, there we go. I'll go take it. One of the things about this, and I wanted to show with this video, is a lot of people don't always
think you got the records, but I have a new strap. I'm taking these out of here. And put them in a newer strap. I just got to get more pages. I don't have enough. Mm-hmm. That is Michelle? Could be Michelle.
That's Michelle. Here's a question, Grandma. How did you get from Georgia to Virginia down to Newport News and then eventually to Trenton?
Well, see, Daddy left us down there and he went to Florida.
Your father.
Yeah.
Where did you go to Florida for? Was it military or was it the church?
Job.
Okay, you went to the job. Okay.
Oh, well, it's another secret, but I don't think I should tell you that.
Okay, not a problem. So he went to Florida.
And then he sent for Mama.
Went down to Florida with him.
My mama.
After that,
he sent for us. That was the longest. I don't like traveling to Florida now. You couldn't even drink the water. It tastes like Epsom salt. It took a week before you got used to it. Mama said, keep putting your mouth in it and you taste it.
Where did you go in Florida? That one Boca Raton, Florida.
Yeah, it's way down in the Key.
That's Florida again. So I just
string beans, bananas. We had those green, what you call them? Round thing.
You talking about apples?
No, it's like an orange.
Apricots or something.
Anyway, to grow in our yard, we should make lemonade out.
That one I did not know.
The food, the special food down there was shrimps.
Uh-huh.
You like that.
I love shrimps.
Red beans. Mm-hmm. Rice. Mm-hmm. And banana pudding.
Oh, boy. So now you went. So you went to Florida. So then, how did you get from Florida to Newport News?
Well, Dad decided he was going to Virginia.
Okay.
So he came to Cape Charles. He brought Lily and Roy.
And you?
No. Nope. He sent us back Maggie and me. Where? Maggie and me. Yeah. I think. And Romadale.
Okay.
We went back, and they sent us back to my grandma, Aunt, Lily. I have a great-grandmother, Lily.
There's a great-grandmother, Lily, okay.
Yeah, she's dying. Yeah. She was Indian, and she had hair longer. Around here.
She was Lily, and then her husband, which would be my great-grandfather.
Yeah.
Great, he was horse.
Yeah, Yeah, he was horse.
He was. His name was Horse.
Yeah.
But now, so that was who? He was born in 18.
Oh my God.
I remember your mother. I remember great grandma telling me she didn't have a social security number when she was born.
No.
And a lot of the people back there, they just gave
me. Neither did us.
Right.
You know what? They say, now, mom said I was born on October 8th.
Right, but then what happened was when the city guy comes.
Yeah, you know, now I have a hard time. I got to get that birth certificate back because when I went to get my undriver license, I had to show it, you know.
Right.
And so they call all the way to Georgia. And they said, well, they say you were born on the 4th. I said, I'm sorry. So they tried to tell me that I was born on the 4th, and the midwife, I was delivered by a midwife.
Right, but see, at that time, when whoever was born that month, the guy comes around that dunce, so everybody had the same birthday.
Yeah. So told them that I was born on the 4th, and she said, well, what one are you going to take? I said, the 8th. And what mom's saying, that was going to be. Well, you know who that is. That's Sam and Robin. That's Romadell's wife and mama. This is Romadell when he retired from the Navy.
So when you, so a couple of them went ahead to Virginia, and then you eventually came back.
Then we stayed, they took us back to Grandma Mamie.
Where she lived?
She lived in Louisville.
Louisville, Kentucky?
Yeah, no, Georgia. Like in the country.
Okay, so you
and, were... So we went there, and we worked and worked, and boy, we stayed. We went to school, started school. We would walk 5 miles to school and 5 miles back.
Ugh. And then and y'all had worked on the farm.
That was a country mouse.
So y'all had to work on a farm, actually, before you get up.
Yeah, to bring the cows in and water them and morning and milk them and take the milk in. And Daddy wrote and said he was coming to get us. So I said, I ain't going.
Why didn't you want to go? I wasn't going,
but he wasn't going to get off that easy. He'd been going for 5 years.
But I know you didn't like working on a farm.
No, and I said, as soon as I get out of there, it's going to be. But when he asked me, was I going with him, I told him no. So everybody was going but me, so he was in the house crying and worrying. So Mama said, MC, she called him MC. Said, if she don't want to go, she just don't want to go. You just leave her here. Go so. It went from, it came, with the last, it was the 9th day. He was supposed to leave that Sunday. So he came, and I came from school. And he was sitting in the room. He said, well, Naomi, you still don't want to go with us. I said, who told you that? I wouldn't stay here if you tried me. He said, you going? I said, yeah. He said, I'm so glad. He said, you were just saying that. I said, you didn't think you were going to get away with leaving us here 5 years and then come back and try to smooth us out.
You're mad because so y'all went to, so y'all lived in the, on the base in Newport, in Denby, in Newport News.
Oh, no, I didn't get, after I got married, I lived in Fort Uses.
Fort Uses, okay, so when y'all, so when
you,
when
you went there, you used to work there.
Yeah, right, so you went,
then,
so when y'all left, so when you left Lawrence?
Yeah, he brought us to Trenton. We went to school and everything down to Trenton. And I went up until the 12th grade, then I left. And then I went back, I was supposed to go to 12th grade.
Okay.
Actually, I was supposed to, I finished 11. Okay. I was supposed to go to 12. I just started out and going back.
So you went from Georgia to New Jersey. You didn't go to Virginia first?
No. I got married. I didn't go to Virginia until I got married.
And then he took you down to Virginia.
Yeah, I'm sorry we don't have a picture of him. I don't know what happened to him. Somebody seemed to just came in the house and got him off.
Well, we'll find. We'll figure that out. So after Florida, you went to Charles County, Virginia, but then you went to Lawrence, Georgia. Then you went
No, I didn't go. No, I ain't never been to Georgia since. Daddy said he wasn't going to take me there because I was going to kill my cousin.
Grandma, you always ready to fight somebody.
Well, I cut his heel off with the axe.
Say that again?
I cut his heel off with the axe.
Why did you cut his heels off with the axe, Grandma?
Well, Mama washed my hair. My hair was red. And Mama washed my hair, and I had gray eyes. I say that my eyes stay gray sometimes. And now it'll change now with the color of the person. If they have a kind of suit I like or something, my eyes will change to a gray. Mm-hmm. Or the color of the suit. Now, Mama washed my hair. It was red. And oh boy, it used to stand up on my head and they called me red. And so, Grandma told me to go get her some chips. This is a little fat thing to cut off the wood, make a fire and a half. And I went out there and I took my dress and folded up and I'm picking up the chip. He came by and pushed my head in the dirt and Grandma was going to whip me. Well, I wasn't going to get a whipping without him getting something.
So I
threw the axe and cut his heel off. So he went hollering in the house. He was 21.
He never walked right since.
No. He said, so they put it back. The doctor put the heel back, the piece on it, cut the end off. Well, you know, I was going
to... Grandma, you come back with a vengeance.
Well, you know, he had no right to do that. I wouldn't bother him.
No, but just...
Yeah, but...
you know that...
You ain't never got a whipping with a switch.
No, but Grandma, but you know... Keep in mind, okay, the family is Native American on that side. Uh-huh. And then, so that just helps add to the fuel, fire of it, coming around with an axe. Everybody come.
Well, he did it.
You walk around with the axe all the time, Grandma. You can't be doing
that. No, I didn't have the axe either. The axe was just laying down. It was like a little hatchet, like. Yeah. He come and took me by the neck and pushed my head down in the dirt. Mama, all that black dirt in my head. Lord, Mama was going to kill me. Grandma was going to beat me.
Why, Grandma? Why?
They don't take kids' word. If the big one said you did something,
that's what you did.
But see, I had to make some proofs.
But you were, you weren't the oldest. Maggie was.
No, I am. It's Lily, and me, and Maggie. See, it goes like this. Lily, me, Maggie. Romadell, Roy, James.
So you were the second oldest. Yeah. But the fact, okay, so... If Maggie, if Maggie knew what happened, why she didn't just back you up?
Nobody but him and me was there, see.
And he was the oldest.
Yeah.
Gosh, that was mean.
Well, I didn't. I wouldn't have did it. I didn't bother him. I was doing what Grandma told me to do.
So when y'all came here to New Jersey?
Yeah, we came here to New Jersey, and the driver gave us the whole back seat because there was so many kids. We rode the bus all the way to New Jersey.
Oh, that was a long ride.
Yeah, it was, and then it was very segregated. Because Mama, Dad, and Lily went to get some food, and you had to go in the back of the restaurant. The white went in the white in the front door. Because when I went to Jehovah's Witness, I went on the side where they said the blacks, and I couldn't find the seat, so I went over to the next place. And so my husband was standing there, so the waitress was waiting on me. And she said, somebody's talking to you. And he said, what? He said, you on the black, on the white side. I said, the food tastes just as good over here. Everybody fell out.
You were playing that segregated mess.
No.
How old were y'all when you moved? What was that, in the 40s?
Early
40s? Like you were 10 or 12?
No, I was going on
13. So this was, this had to be 46.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay.
And we came to Prospect Village. It was nice. It was a nice project. It had three bedrooms, bath, kitchen, dining room.
Three bedrooms and all your kids?
Yeah. See, all the boys slept in the back room. Okay. Mom, Dad sat in the middle room. The girls sat in the first room. It was big, like big, long. You could get two beds, four beds on each side.
Oh, my.
It was good. And it had a beautiful lawn. And when it snowed, like this, we used to put on our bathing suits and go sit on the snow. Tell the police that he was going to arrest us. I thought it was crazy.
How was it like trying to keep a house it's easier when you got 8 kids versus working on in a house. Mom, an apartment. Mom, I'm retired, but I know I'm just saying, but like, how it's a lot easier keeping a house clean versus keeping a farm clean. So what was it like?
No, it's better because we leave at 4:30 in the morning. We don't turn back till 4:30 in the evening. And we had to go to school. We didn't go to school till we could go to school all the winter. Uh-huh. It was cold and raining. And
when you were up here, obviously. Down there, you can't go to school when it's winter.
Oh, that's what I'm trying to say. Yeah, we went to school for winter. They would walk, honey. They put us on coaches and we went. And but we only went to school till May. That's when the farm started. They started prying up the ground, and we had to, like, give, they didn't have, like, they have things here now. As they go, a horse pulled the ply, and we hand them the fertilizer, and they put it in this thing, and it goes.
So, but now, how was it cleaning, keeping the house clean here in New Jersey?
Oh, it was kind of hard, because Lily cooked. Mm-hmm. I clean and iron. Okay. Lily cooked and wash, I clean and iron.
What did the boys do?
Well, you know, I ain't got to do it. And Maggie cleaned up the boys and put them to bed. We all had our duties.
So the women did was being all the women were older, all the women were in charge.
Mm-hmm. And Mama said she wanted everything ironed so good so a fly would fall out.
So what did Mama do all the time?
Stay gone. Daddy worked the pen light, Siegfried's paper company.
Saint who?
Saint Ridge.
Saint Ridge Paper Company.
Yeah. See, they made something like, see that was different now. You know how the old-fashioned, those for the refrigerator? Mm-hmm. He made them, they're funny, they were made out of material. Mm-hmm. And what they did was put in a hot press and it formed that way.
How much did they pay them an hour back then?
We made good money.
Was it like $4? I mean,
in the factory, they paid more than that. I don't know exactly much, but
because back then, I remember Grandma saying something about he got like 4 or 6, but that was good. But it was like $20 a week.
I was thinking, something like that.
And that was good.
Oh
money.
Yeah, I remember my daddy worked for 50 cents a week.
Wait, that was on the farm. When he was in the factory, he was like $20 a week.
Mm-hmm. He made good, and well, things wasn't so bad. See. Like, that 3 room at the house didn't cost but $65.
Oh, really?
We can get that now.
You ready to say it? The whole house, 3-bedroom house and everything in Prospect Village was $65.
And we didn't pay no gas and electric. We only furnished our heat.
Wait. You had wood, or you talking about they gave you the...
They had oil.
And they gave
a great big old furnace in the house. It's a big old oil one like you would probably find in a factory. But it was beautiful, and they put first it was coal, and then they converted to oil.
I could not imagine getting.
Oh, you just put the ashes out on the curb. The garbage man take it. The garbage man came 3 times a day.
Now I'm just trying to think of like $65 for a house.
Yeah, 3-bedroom. Can you imagine?
I'll buy a whole bunch of them today if I could.
Hey, you know what? And they didn't have no ice box, no refrigerator.
So what did y'all do to keep stuff cold?
We had to buy a rock of ice and put it underneath the ice box.
So what did you do with the frozen meat? How did you keep the frozen meat?
Well, that's it. That ice would keep it frozen. It would freeze it.
So that block of ice will last how long a day?
Oh, about 4 days.
4 days.
So then we had an ice man. He come by and get it.
So y'all had...
We had an ice man, a milkman, a fish man.
Ice man, a milkman, a fish man.
And a chicken man.
Oh gosh! Did they still deliver the powder detergent back then?
No, you had to buy your things, but it was cheap. Like a box of salt was 9 cents.
But now wasn't okay.
Then a loaf of bread was 10 cents, and then it went up to 15 cents.
Now how did my great grandfather, your father, how did he not be in the military back then?
I don't know. I escaped because he was a minister. Maybe that.
Oh well, that's he was a minister, right. But like so. He worked at the factory, and then he ministered at the churches.
Yeah, he was assistant pastor at Beauty Grove.
Beauty Grove, until he became the head pastor.
Yeah, it's because the pastor died. Mm-hmm. And he became the pastor because he was... Then Alicia got it now.
So how did you...
Do you know who this is?
That is... That's my niece.
And this is?
That's Angel?
That's Keith.
Keith, oh man.
What? I talked to him the other day here.
Oh boy. How did you get from New Jersey, from Trenton, New Jersey, down to Virginia?
I got married.
You got married.
And he burned all my pictures because he thought the cousin Bride magazine wanted them. I was sitting in a pale green gown with a long train. And I was sitting with my brother-in-law, got an uncle, he's dead now, they say he is, Johnny Johnson magazine. I was sitting in the back of the car with my guitar. I played the guitar there.
You played the guitar, Grandma?
Yeah, with my brother got on. And my husband didn't like it. He was jealous of everything.
Okay, tell me about the first Anna Berta and Jerome's that guy. He was German or?
Yeah, he was German. Jack Buter.
Jack Buter.
Say he's dead now. I don't know. But I was talking to a guy who lived in Indian Falls. He told me his name was Buter. I asked him and said, yeah, did it spell B-E-U-T-E-R? He said, yeah. How'd you know? I said, well, I just thought. I don't want to know because I don't want, if he's alive, I don't want him to find me.
How did you meet him and what made you be with him?
Oh, I was coming home from work and it was a storm. Mm-hmm. It was raining cats and dogs. And the lightning looked like it was dancing in front of me. I was too scared to go to school to stay. So I kept walking, so he told me, come on, and you take me home. I told him, no. No. Couldn't do that, so I ran on home. I didn't ride with him. But then he still kept following me. He kept following me. He kept following me. Oh, well.
That's a stalker.
Yeah. Well, yeah, he knew what he wanted.
How old were you back then?
I could have been 15.
15. Oh, my. So you, how old when you had on a birth? Or Jerome was the first?
52.
How old were you when you?
Oh, I think I was 17.
Oh my. So what made you start dating him?
Oh, he was having the most gorgeous man in the world. Well, this is what you call, what you say, you're talking about how to raise kids. Well, my family raised me, but I felt like I did all the work and most of the work and they didn't love me. It's called looking for love in the wrong place. Mm.
So he got you hooked up and things of that nature. He was, was he in the military too?
Yeah, he was in the military, but he was out there.
But he was older.
Yeah, he wanted to take me back to Germany with him. I didn't want to go.
How old was he?
Oh, he was grown.
Like his 40s?
No, he was in his early 30s, but he's a gorgeous man. He was really gorgeous.
So you have a thing for military men in uniform?
Not really. He was out when I met him.
Oh, okay. But they had that look, that style.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he was nice. He was really nice. This is good. I want you to look at that.
Oh, yes. I remember this one. I remember all of that.
That's how Mamie Lou, she gone. Mm-hmm. She deceased, too. That's Mama's sister.
Who was this?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
That's you.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, that is me.
You ain't ugly.
Oh, my goodness.
Who's that?
That's you, Grandma. I can't believe I'm seeing these pictures. It's like how small. I know I wasn't skinny in many, but.
Oh, you ain't seen none yet.
I was telling some people the other things, like I was bare when I graduated high school. I was 120 pounds. Now I'm like 218 now, but it got big. But this is now I'll show you everybody my Laura Park love. This was I think this was 8 or 9 years old. This was Elmer. My Ness and Uncle Scorp, and Kat was...
He dumped and married a white woman.
Oh.
What did? Mine dumped me. This is your Uncle Rumadel.
Oh, yes, I remember that one. I remember that one. I'm going to take this picture, too.
Don't worry, save some room for another one.
No problem. I'll put this one back.
He had a patient for about 20 years.
So what made you leave? So the first guy, what made you leave him or he left you? After the honor of the other.
I met Harry.
Okay.
My cousin.
So you left him to go with him?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Do you know those?
Yes.
This is Alberta.
Well, Alberta.
You know where I'm coming from, don't you?
Work?
No, a funeral.
Oh,
I'm on a funeral.
Grandma. Oh, that's why I remember that.
Yeah, you should. And that's your mother.
I remember that.
That's her, Lillian. Her daughter. She got five kids, not married.
You was only 53?
I don't think 50. I was in my 50s.
No, it was 44. It had to be almost 50 because grandma. I remember I was 6 or 7 when she died. No, yeah, I was 6 or 7 when great grandma passed.
Yeah, you were with your mother.
So I was 7 or 8 then. So you were 40. So it was about 50, 51.
I don't know how old I was. I really don't.
What made you like Harry? Calvin Harris called him Harry. What made you?
Oh, my girlfriend. It was a street guy. Lily didn't marry hers. And Robert took her. Robert took her. She liked Robert better than she did it.
Okay.
Her first boyfriend was, with the three boys, was Triplet, Calvin, and Joe.
So y'all just picked whoever liked whatever.
I liked Harry instantly.
Okay.
Because I really never went with anybody. Daddy was cruel. He didn't like us to go with anybody. I think that's why we got in so much trouble.
Because he was so strict.
Yeah, that's Eric.
Oh my. So great granddaddy. Great granddaddy was strict, so he didn't.
Want was he ever?
I don't remember he was strict. We had to line up before we walk in church. We had to walk in church in a line.
Sure did.
And sit down, even if we were just gonna go play. We had to walk in line to go inside and walk in line to go outside.
Hey, this is old, but this is quite a few pages.
Oh, my gosh. I hate this picture.
Look at this one.
Oh, boy. I couldn't fit in a shirt.
Why not? You seem to be all right there.
Oh, gosh.
And that man done your teeth is great. I asked Bellman, was he still around? I can get him to put my teeth back in. That's Romadale's last stepson.
Mm-hmm. I remember all of these and stuff like that.
Yeah. Hey, look at that.
Oh, gosh.
You were young then.
All these dang schools. I am going to have to take this one up. I'm telling on myself. I said, the only reason why I'm doing this is because Grandma, what happens?
They don't believe you.
Well, not only that, you know, I take a lot of pictures, Grandma, and I catch people off guard all the time.
Yeah.
And in pictures, and they hate me with me coming around the camera because I'm always snapping stuff and they're crazy. So I said, it's only fair. And therefore, I take pictures.
I agree with them.
I figured you would. Oh boy, this is the flash is
Yeah, that's a good picture there of you. I like that silhouette on it. That's really good. That's before you had your teeth fixed.
Oh gosh.
Bucky Beaver.
Yeah, I understand. But oh my goodness, these.
Well, that happened to boys with children who the mother gave a Bible too young.
Or too late.
Yeah.
I didn't get the bottle. I got the bottle most of the time. That's all I had.
Oh yeah, you throw it hit me side of the head with it.
I don't know what.
Oh, you should get that one. That's cute. That's a handsome picture.
I got it. This one, so I figure I'll be fair and take all these. I gotta put this one back.
Oh, you don't know these, but you should know them because he was there with them.
So y'all came down to Newport News, Fort Eustace.
Yeah, I got married and I came down there, and then stayed there for quite a while, and then I got pregnant and Harry started acting up. He put the chaplain on me.
Well, you put the chaplet on you.
Yeah, told me I wasn't being a good wife. I told him, yeah. You see that basket sitting there? He said, yeah. I said, well, he told me he'll be right back in there. Take us right to the beach. Fix the basket of food. And I fixed the basket of food. We opened the basket. That's good food. I said, yeah. And I said, I was carrying Albert, a friend of Albert. And he come back 4 o'clock and told me, come on, let's go to the beach. I'm ready to take it now. I told him,
4 o'clock too late. Yeah, you got to get all the way. Which beach did y'all go to?
Hey, we're going to Myrtle Beach.
But he said, wait, you already around a bunch of beaches. Why go all the way down to Myrtle Beach when you have...
Well, then they just mock you. It would slap you on your arm, you know, on the back of your hand. So if you go out, they come back. Mm. Oh, yeah, he was out there with his girlfriend and everything. Then when he decided to come. Then he took and slapped me. Bad, bad, bad,
bad. Bad move.
Then he went and come back to the house and for something, and jumped in his car and run. I took both tags off and threw them in the river.
Glad there was no axe around then.
Hey, I nailed up the whole house. Every window and door.
You nailed out every window and door in the house.
Yeah, only me and Alberto was in there. He couldn't get in. So he didn't, he told him to come out and go down to the sheriff's office. No, I ain't going nowhere. He said he was coming home, and the troopers pulled him aside and told him, you think you're smart? He said, no, sir. I'm not smart. Yeah, soldiers think they're smart. Mm-hmm. And he said, no, sir, I don't know what you're talking about. He said, you don't have any tag on. Yeah. So they took him to jail. And the MPs came and got him and took him to Fort Houston.
And put him in jail there.
Yeah. So then somehow they got him out. I don't know. But he came back to the house and said to me, I took the bows off the house then. I was really happy. Me and Albert, we had a good time.
But how were you going to get out if you nailed the door?
Well, that's all right. We got out. So she would take the hammer and let the nails out. Well, you know what? He come back and he said to me, I nailed me. I think I might have to scar my arm where he got. He didn't cut me. It got a raw edge on his collar, you know, near it. Mm-hmm. And I put my arm in there to hit him, and I cut my arm. And that made me twice as mad. And I was pregnant, too. Well, he's in there on me. Tell me the truth. I just want to know. He said, you going to let me back in the house? Nope.
Would you let him back in eventually?
Yeah, I let him back in eventually because I was going. I went to get on the bus and he took and grabbed me off the bus. And then he said, did you take my tags off? I said, yeah. You ever think you can do anything to me and get away with it? I said, you hit me, and I said, that's it. You know, that's terrible. So he said, where did you? I'll give you $150. I said, ooh, I can go home if you, tell me where you put the tags.
Yeah, they're in the river.
So I took the money, took it over to my girlfriend and gave it to her. And then because he'd take it from me. I was clumsy. Real fat with Albert, what in that film or another. And I told him and went to him in the river and he could just see a little bit of sick and heavy dive down and got him. But this is Sam and Ronisha. This is Big Sam, the father, and Rosalind. This is Sam, and I think she's carrying Ronisha. I don't know who that is.
You told me.
This is Joshua. This is Raina. This is Joshua.
You told me a story, like in the news. I'm always very big on, you know, everybody fusses at me and says, you know, I've got to be, because I'm, you know, black, you're supposed to be around, I was sport only black.
You're not black, they don't even touch the name of a black person. You may be a dark brown, but you're not black. Put you on the magazine, see. Hey, Judas, this is fresh. No father sent me a bunch of roses because I let him stay all night because he had a flat tire. And I put it there.
I remember you would tell me that, what happened is I'm always, went on the radio and online. I post a lot of information on, because I tell people my family is, my roots is in a whole bunch of cultures.
Yeah,
so I would tell them that, you know, it's heavily Native American.
That's right.
And heavily Asian. And
your great-grandfather was the same color you are.
Oh, I understand.
Grandpa Charlie, but didn't have a straight of an arrow. He didn't have a crook.
Your grandfather.
Yeah, your great-great-grandfather.
Wait, okay, which one is this?
That is my dad's father.
Okay, he was horse.
No, it was Charlie.
Okay, it was Charlie. The father before that was horse.
Horse, yeah.
I'm trying to remember which picture it was.
Lily Mae Fleming, that was her husband. Now, Mamie Lee Young was Grandpa Charlie's wife.
Okay, and then Charlie's father was horse. Because I remember seeing a picture, and I couldn't remember that was Charlie.
Yeah, fell in the cabin.
Oh, yeah, fell in the cabin. I remember that. Because I couldn't remember if that was Charlie or horse. I couldn't remember. Or Charlie horse.
Charlie or horse. But darling.
Charlie's dad's name was horse. That's just funny.
Hey, this is good. Who's this?
That was me.
Yeah, we're coming from the grandma's funeral.
Yeah, see, this is where. Oh my goodness.
What did I do? They don't believe you were little.
Now this was Kingsbury Square.
Yeah. Hey, this is good. This is where I worked at, and I had retired.
Mm-hmm.
And was I retired? No, I wasn't retired, but I had a. Had like 4 weeks off, you know, for a few months. And this is Marianne, my co-worker, and guess what? They sent me $250 that time.
Oh, man.
That was very nice.
That $250 is big back then.
Mm. Hey, tell them this is your old grandma.
Nah, I'm going to take this. I can't believe. This is where I tell everybody, see, here's the...
Hey, we kept everything.
No, but see, no, everybody tell me why I'm into fashion so much, but I don't dress it like so much. But I can't believe...
You were
what was this?
Oh, this is, I forgot his name, but it's Kurt.
No, that's me.
That's not you.
I had that outfit. That's me.
My dad, no, this is not you. This is a Kurt Wright. What's his name? New Kurt.
No, that is me, Grandma. Because that was I can tell
you.
You.
Yeah,
that,
yeah,
that, that's the long. No, that's the I can tell you. That's the Long Park watch.
Hey, there's your lamp.
Yeah, where was this at?
I don't know. Probably at your house because it had to be at your house
This is gonna cause a riot.
Hey, look at this here. This is what's that building called? I can't even remember that building. But it was where it is. Oh, this could be East Sheldon, but I don't know. Yeah, that's easy. Oh, that's Roy's girlfriend.
Hey,
I got them too.
You got all the girlfriends.
Yeah, this is Lillian Joe deceased. Isn't that something? A lot of people gone.
Now, remember, I was telling you that you told me a story about...
Hey, you got him.
Oh, gosh. You told me, see, one thing for sure I'll tell everybody, I dressed up.
Yeah.
When I dressed up, I remember this. Y'all can't see this one, but I was super cool then.
Yeah, you were about what? I don't know.
This was, I was what?
About 7, maybe.
Oh, Jesus. Ah, Lord have mercy. I want to say 6 or 7. I'm going to take this one. What, I wore a suit. This was a vest. This was a double, I had a double-breasted suit and everything.
Yeah, you were sharp. Oh, I bought you, what's his name, Roy Bean? Remember you had your cap and the coat matching?
Oh, yes.
And it's like, wow, where'd you get that from? Look who's here. This is for somebody. If she saw that picture, she'd tear it up.
Who? Oh, gosh. Yeah, she would not like that one.
Hey, take this one.
Oh, no. Oh, gosh. That one will be so big bad.
Hey, you ready for this one?
Oh, gosh. Hold on. I'm going to grab that one.
You a baby.
Let me put this.
You were just born.
Oh, boy. I'm going to put, oh, geez, this is the cake.
Yeah, that's around the 16th birthday. She had run a movie so much, so I may have got married.
That's a big, this one goes.
Well, I dropped one over here.
I get it, Grandma. I get it. But now, you reason I was asking earlier, Grandma, was you were telling me a story, and I tell this story all the time to people. That, you know, it's always good to tell your children these stories because, hold on, let me sit this over here.
It's right, but it'll be all right.
I remember telling these stories because it's important that our children know our history.
Yeah, well, see, the people doesn't believe you when you're telling them different things.
Because it's important because with certain things. Because what happens is that you forget our culture, you forget your history.
Yeah.
And
hey, I ain't about to forget it.
No, you told me a story about. Let me put this one back. You told me about 27 minutes ago, I think. But you told me a story about how you came to Richmond. They were very mean to Native Americans, but how they. You have came up and got your ticket early.
Oh, yeah.
And then they still made you sit in the fields for a day or something like that. And somebody had a baby in a field. And
oh, yeah, you had to sit on the, you had to sit on the shade of the cotton. And, yeah, I babysit for a while. You're not going to take that one?
Okay, I'll take this one. I want to tell the story, and correct me if I'm wrong. You told me you were going to New Jersey somewhere for something. And you got your tickets early, but they wouldn't let you on the train because they had no more room.
Oh, well, this was here I got a ticket, and my driver, driver's license,
mm-hmm.
ID had just expired, and I didn't know it.
No, not that one. No, this was when you were younger. You said one of the reasons why you don't want to go to Richmond because of the.
Oh yeah, when we come there that you got your ticket early, yeah, but. They won't let you get on the bus. You know, you have to go get in and sit in the back.
But on the train, they wouldn't let you on the train because they didn't want Native Americans. They told y'all to get off the train.
I think I was with them. Daddy told us that.
Okay.
Yeah, that they made them go. They was in Winston-Salem. They went to get something to eat and they got back on the train. And to get back on the train, they didn't want to let them on.
And so you went, and they.
Got the bus.
Okay. I remember the bus story.
Yeah.
Okay, and the train story was they wouldn't let you on and had to wait the next day, and then you had to sit in the rain in the field off of Staples. You remember the name before I even told you Staples Mill.
Yeah.
In downtown.
So much is going on in our life, I can't all remember it all. That is you.
And this was me.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh. Sure this is me?
Yeah, that's you.
Oh, my goodness.
You kept your hand to your eye.
My eyes was always puffy then.
Take that baby's eye. Well, you couldn't be no more than a couple of days old.
Mm-hmm.
I thought you were cute.
I tell everybody I was always losing hair. You know what?
You had pretty good hair. I used to comb it down in your face. You could tell you was you. You're very young there. You couldn't have been no more than about. You could have been just about a couple of hours old.
This one looked like a couple of hours old.
Yeah.
And then let's see. I'm trying to get a good angle.
There's your great grandma. I should have wrote on you know, the date and everything on there.
That's no problem.
No time. I never did have time. Just stick them in there.
That's no problem. Hey, grab the photos when you can. Yeah. And take it.
This is a great grandma.
Oh, my goodness. This is on a bird's...
Yeah, that's Eric, Brian, Keith and Michelle.
I'm going to send this, Michelle. If you see this video ever, I'm going to take this picture. And I'm going to send this to you right now and text it to you.
This is Keith now. He's a great big man now.
Yeah, and I'm going to send this
see, to you. See that picture I told you about, first president, vice president?
Yeah.
That's Keith's son. He told me he was going to come to see me. He was going to walk. I told him, no, honey, you can't walk to him. I think you have to ride.
Understand.
Guess who?
Oh, gosh. I sent, I got a picture of this one somewhere, I think. Oh, boy. This is crazy. I
paid a whole lot of money on that picture today.
How much was picture back then, Grandma?
Oh, it ran from about $25 to $35 a month. I had the man come out to the house and take that one.
Yeah, because I wouldn't leave.
No, your mother wanted one, and you wouldn't go. So I had to stuck with it. Hey, this your jet. You can take that one. Christmas tree.
Oh, my gosh. You got the picture of the American Airlines jet.
Yeah.
This was the jet they gave everybody.
Yeah.
Also, it's red and white.
Yeah, well, it looks white because of the picture.
Oh, my gosh. Where was this, at Kingsbury Square?
Yeah, just right here.
Whose dog was that? I was mad because I wanted that dog.
Yeah, that
stuffed
was your dog. All that was your stuff.
Now, one thing I remember, some of the kids didn't have anything. I gave away toys to them,
yeah,
too.
You did give some of them. But you had too many things. If I saw something I thought you'd like, I'd buy it.
There was not. I don't recall anything you broke, Grandma, that I did not like.
Well, I mean, what I mean, you got tired of it.
What made me so kind and giving to give all these stuff away all the time?
Well, I told you, to treat people right. That if they don't treat you right, you treat them right. You took it in. You tell me I don't want to do it.
because I'm always trying to help people to show their kids, and I know they get mad at me for it, but try to, you know, we're missing that grandmother element, the grandfather element of teaching lessons.
This is who I took you apart and took and grabbed in the jello. This is grandmother's taking care of you, then you're sleeping on the floor. She made your little pallet down on the floor.
Now this looks like
that's you and me. Who was that at the church?
Who was this?
That was
me. Was that me or that was me? That was somebody else. This is me.
Yeah, well, that's you too, because you took him, put your hand in the jello. No, that could have been Ronisha.
That's Ronisha.
Yeah, I think that's Ronisha.
I did put my hands in the jello, but that wasn't that picture. No. That's Ronisha.
Could you read that? I see what that was. Well, that's you in that stroller.
Mother and Eric.
My son was Eric,
yeah. Oh, yeah, that was at Ashbury Park.
Yeah. Hey, that's me. I go ahead and be bitten, didn't
you? What did you do for fun back then, Grandma, to have fun before you got married and the kids? What did you go to Ashbury Park? Did you, you know, you went?
I worked myself to death.
At the hospital?
Mm-hmm. This is me here. Somebody was taking my picture, and I told her. I looked back, and I said, hey, and then I went in the door and posed.
But you did a lot, and you gave your money to the family to help keep the house.
Oh, yeah, the kids, you know. Oh, here went another handsome man.
I can't believe it. It's hard to remember. I know I was skinny. It's just that in the face.
This one you had, you should give me that one because you'd had your teeth fixed. This is not you, but I wonder who.
No.
I think it's Michelle.
No, that was, Sam.
No, that's not Sam.
Sam or Ronisha. Yeah.
No, you know what it is? Vanessa's baby.
Stephanie.
Yeah. Because what happened was that They didn't know that she was handicapped.
Oh, yeah.
She walked her 6 months old.
Oh, yeah, I remember. Yeah. Oh, boy. Here's a Blessed Sacrament. It's sad when you remember the doggone school. Blessed Sacrament Elementary, I think it was.
Is that where you were? You were handsome there, didn't you?
Oh, my God. No, the kids used to get on me all the time. My lips were bigger then than it is now.
Yeah, you didn't have your teeth fixed.
Wait. No, actually, two grandma, winter, spring, 1988, 12 years old. Gosh. Wait a second, this is 80. Wait, oh, yeah, this is right before I moved here, because I moved here in 88.
Hey, this is Curtis and the parrot. The parrot died now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this was the last picture I took in New Jersey before I moved here to Virginia. Oh, in that accident. And
that's
in
Newark.
Yes, this was in Newark. I want to say because I went. It was the winter spring picture. The spring semester I went to Peshine.
Yeah, because
elementary.
Hey, you were gorgeous. You were dressed sharp then. Hey, you tell me, come on, Grandma, get out of bed. It's time for Mickey Mouse. And Mickey's like doing his exercises.
Oh, the Mickey Mouse exercises every day.
Hey, I get up and say, do like this. Come on, Grandma, raise your arms.
Hey, I was fit. I could run. I couldn't when asthma was messing with me, but I made it. I made it there. What's one thing we could do, Grandma? Like right now, what's with all the all the killings, Grandma? I would tell people that back then, there was crime in Jersey and stuff like that. But we played outside, regardless of the age, because nobody messed with the kids and nobody.
No, but not. They come. They see. They had security guards.
That and then that's the thing I remember. Me and I'll tell Marcus J. He'll remember. I think we had a talk or a discussion about this, but the what's the gentleman with the red hat? So forgive me. They had local people organize the church, and we used to walk the streets.
Oh yeah, they call it a night watch.
Right, but they were an offshoot of the people in New York. And please forgive me, I'm talking about the gentleman with the hats that used to watch and guard and protect the neighborhoods.
Oh yeah, well that's what they call the watch, the city watch or night watch.
Right, but this was the other. The city had sent the cops out.
Yeah, but
we had our own group, community group.
Yeah, like Prospect Village, they had their own people.
Right. See, we had our own people.
And you couldn't come up there.
And so what they did was that the people in the community, we weren't going to... Now, everybody knew not to mess with kids anyway. But just in case somebody was foolish enough...
That's right.
So there were people... They had guns. Mm-hmm. I can't say they were illegal.
They had sticks, too.
They had... I remember...
My sticks, too.
I remember a guy named Curtis... had a, I knew he had a gun, but yeah, I knew he had a bat.
I know you're telling me that, Curtis, but you said, oh, there go old Curtis.
But he had...
How about that big old dog y'all had? I just scared to death of that dog.
Oh, you're talking about Brutus? Mm-hmm. But what they did was, what we don't do now is, like, they walked and protect the community. Mm-hmm. And I wish...
They're called night watchers. I think they got a much time on my name.
Yeah. But now I wish that what happened to that in, because I think of Chicago, I think of what goes on Oregon, even, because every time I turn on, you turn on the news, these kids, and they're not involved.
Oh, they're bad.
They're killing them, stray bullets, and then this, the one major one, well, they're all major, but the one that got the news recently, they executed a poor child, lured him in the alleyway.
Yeah, I was reading about that. But listen, Velma said they're pretty, not Velma, Alberta said it was pretty bad because her son was in trouble with them all the time. And when she made him stop in that gang, they came up there to get her.
Yeah, because the gangs just didn't understand, and we need to work on that.
And when we was going to church, the church was going to Chicago for a visiting meeting, and... they told us not to wear our scarves on different on the side of the way because it was a gang, assigned to a gang.
You could do because
yeah,
of the
if
gang.
You wore it that way, it mean the gang, you know, it was signifying them or something.
Oh Jesus!
Hey, this is Grandpa on his last leg before Grandpa died.
He passed before Grandma.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he did.
Yes.
Hey, who's that lady? Do you know that lady here?
This is my mom.
Yeah, she had a job working at the state office.
I can't see. I would love to get this picture, but you can't see.
It's bad.
It's so... You keep it anyway.
Yeah, I mean, there's a picture behind me. Look like I got a long earring, but that's a picture behind me.
That's you, Grandma?
Yeah, that's me.
Oh,
who else?
Go ahead, girl. Told everybody you fine.
No, I ain't. I was still in my early, late 30s.
So this was before I was even born.
I don't even think. Your mother hadn't grown up yet.
No, Jesus. No.
Like her right here, she's only 60. They was going to put your mother in there. Your mother was, what was she? She was 12 years old? 11 years old? They was going to put her in the 11th grade.
Yeah, when was she saying she was in school?
Oh, no, it ain't. I say, no, let her go naturally. You know?
Yeah, I remember she was saying they wanted to move her up.
Oh, yeah. Don't know. She couldn't go to college because she's too young.
Well, see, they let you, see, they did actually in some schools because there were a lot of kids that bright. They have, they have a couple of kids now. Well, not a couple. There's a lot of kids that.
His dad.
Yes. There's a lot of kids now growing. They start college. They take you in high
school.
Yeah,
they take you now, but they didn't take you back there.
And things,
That's Nathan's foot. That's Sam's footprints.
This is Aunt Alberta.
Yeah, she hugging you. You're her favorite child.
I gotta take this picture and send it to Michelle. Whose feet pictures were those?
That's Sam's. I think it's Sam's.
It's a baby girl rough.
Yeah. Oh, was that Ronisha's? That's Ronisha's footprint then.
Back then when you were born, you actually take pictures and painted the feet because that's how they used to...
Yeah, print. They still take the footprint.
Footprint, yeah.
Hey, look at me again. I think this is the same day.
Oh, boy. I'm trying to make sure this is a card, the picture, flash. Got it.
This must be the same day.
Yes,
yeah, because this is your mother in the same hat. That's Roy and his girl. His Roy is gone.
Mm-hmm. Well, girl, I know the video is going to run out of here soon in a few minutes and stuff like that.
Yeah, this is Stephanie. Mm-hmm. This is me. This is Alberta. She had Alberta had a...
Grandma, what could you do if you had, if you could, you're 82 now. If you could tell your, I asked this question a whole lot. If you could go back and talk to an 18-year-old Naomi, what would you tell her now?
Naomi, don't get into babies.
Don't get into babies.
No. Don't get into babies. Have some fun before you do it. Become a nurse with a master's degree.
What would you tell these young girls going through all this stuff nowadays?
Forget it, honey. Don't do nothing. Go to school and get a career.
And forget these men.
Yeah, because if you have a good career, mm-hmm, and he don't treat you, get this one.
Oh, boy.
This is the one I was telling you about. I was in the church and you grabbed it.
Oh, yeah, that's the one I grabbed the Jell-O in.
Yeah.
But say that last thing you get, Grandma. The camera, I know it's a little crazy, but the camera battery ran out. But you said to have a, what do you say for those?
Yeah, get a career. You know, go to school and get a career. Okay, boys and I talk, but stay a bit distant. Because they can mess you up, but they can go and get away with it. And you got that baby to take care of.
Because so many of them get caught over and then they get in trouble over and over again.
If you got one, don't go get another one. Mm-hmm. Because you're only tying yourself down. You're not acting smart and you're being wise because nobody's going to keep that baby. You're going to have to take it to nursing school.
I have a lot of, a daycare, you mean? Oh, yeah. Yes, I see that one. But now you, the other thing about it is, I have a lot of women friends that are doing a lot with running their own, I see that one. I have a lot of women friends that's running their own business. Mm-hmm. Or their career, or they on their second marriages and third marriages, and you know, how did you survive after the first guy and the second guy with the kids and stuff like that? What kept you going?
Oh, meanwhile, Albert and Jerome, the daddy don't know it, but they strictly sisters and brother. Jack is their father. Mm-hmm. They only had one daddy. Mm-hmm. And one, but I didn't tell him, because he just get smart. Mm-hmm. And now, how you say, tell them?
No, I was like, what would you tell these younger women that's going through these multiple marriages? These guys are abusing them. They're trying to run their own business. A lot of women got their own businesses now, doing wonderful.
Okay, sit down and talk with them. That's right. And get a whole business. If you're a hairdresser, do hair. You know, some of my hairdressers, and mm-hmm. they're really doing good.
Yeah, a lot of them are selling hair. They mm-hmm. run their own talent groups. That's right. They got their own accounting firms.
They got their own career.
Yeah, I have some lawyers. They're accounting firms. I got a couple of doctors.
Just because you made one mistake, that ain't a mistake because you knew what you're doing. Hey, look, why not go to school if you have to go to night school?
What about those who are okay? There's a lot of, I don't have too many that now even finish school. A lot of them are, but they just struggling.
Just because you get a baby, I don't think you should stop out of school.
Mm-hmm. No. A lot of them are finished school and they're doing well in the career, but they just going through so much mess because of how life is treating them with the jobs and other things. And some of them are struggling to try to make it through because they've had relationships that's not working well. Or
you know what? Mm-hmm. As long as you sign my check, that's fine. Heck with the guys.
So in other words, just keep getting the check and don't worry about you. Soon forget about it.
Yeah, come on, forget about it. Look, one thing about it, I could say, look, you're not pulling the kids, right? Mm-hmm. And you won't give me any money to help with the kids. Your kids, they could say something smart. Mm-hmm. You know what they say? That's the last I see to you. You better not come around my house. You better not call me. You better come near the kids. Because if you do, and they ain't going to come because they're going to have to pay.
Well, now, the kids need their father.
No, look.
Well, you raised me. I'm not going to dare say nothing to you. Because
no, I'm going to tell you a good story. My husband came to me. He had been living all over the place, sleeping with my girlfriend, darn everyone. And he came to me one night and he said to me, you're doing fine. I had to fixed up beds and things, and they had a finished attic and looking good. I had my bed in one corner, the crib over the other corner, and Alberta and Annette and Velma in one bed, and the other two in the cribs, you know. And it was nice. I was sitting down on the floor ironing some clothes, and because I was carrying a rosin, I didn't know I was pregnant at the time until I maybe got sick. Milk was too young for her. And I didn't know I was pregnant. So he come and told me to my dad, Naomi, I'm going to get the kids a TV and I'll be back and bring it to them tomorrow. That tomorrow never came.
And neither did he.
No, I went to see where he lived at and my lady told me he had gone. I think he stopped by to say he was going. He just didn't have the nerve to say it. It was best to say it.
You said that you thought he was with the mob and so they came.
Yeah, well, they probably was looking for him because he had took $1,000. $1,000 may not be much to him.
To today, about $1,000 back then, you messing around.
Yeah.
And back in the 50s.
Those gangs, they'll kill you. And I tell you what, he could be in custody. I don't know. I don't call it that because if he's in custody, he needs to stay in custody.
Yeah.
Well, his mother tells me, No, I think it's Maggie. Maggie tells me if he come back, would I take him back? No, I'm afraid not. Because if he can live without me 60 years, can he continue? I was just turning 26 years old when he left.
Hey, but you've made it. How did you, because a lot of the family didn't help out.
Well, they was too young. See, a half a day.
You had five, but you were pregnant with the last one. So you had four born.
I was working for a doctor. I was taking Maggie's place, but the doctor didn't know.
Right. So you have, but you have four, and then you have pregnant with one, with Rosalind. He's gone. So what was your first thought as back in the 50s? Okay. You're a single mother, four kids, one on the way, and the father's gone and by yourself. What was your first thing in your mind when you got together?
I need to get up and get a job. I need a job. See, because somebody told me to go on welfare. And I didn't get along. I had to go. I got me a job. What I did, see, it used to be, before you start school, you go a half a day and you go and come back for lunch.
And then you go to work.
No, you come to the house and get your lunch. The kids, school kids came for at home for lunch. Mm-hmm. Then they eat their lunch and go back to school.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was bad for me because if I got a full-time job, they won't let me do that. Won't let me home. So what I did was scrub floors.
At night?
No, in the day. I made $12 in car fare a day, and I used the car fare and walked home and saved the money. At the end of the week, I bought a whole mile of grocery and clothes and stuff.
So who watched them while they?
They was in school.
Okay, so they just ate lunch at school.
Mildred, you don't.
I remember Mildred. Okay.
So she took care of them. She just saw that they got the lunch and went to school. When I moved on Calhoun Street, Miss Tucker done it. She would come over and lock the door.
So the community worked with each other back then.
Yeah, the ladies and was nice. They know you, and they know your kids, and they would. You ask them to do a favor, they do it. And she would come over and lock the door for me.
Mm-hmm.
And see that the kids, I'd be made the lunch and left it for them. You know.
How did you make it with trying to get clothes for all the women, you know, my brother, my mom, Velma, Aunt Ness, and Rosalind, all of them were different size women.
Hey,
all they couldn't share clothes. So how did you make it?
Old sewing machine. I used to buy, you know, great big men?
Uh-huh.
You know, men with the big legs.
Oh, yeah.
I got the pants from the Goodwill.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had them clean. Mm-hmm. It was already clean, and I haven't cleaned. Well, if you cut the leg open, two legs, you can make a good jumper out of that.
And you just made it with that.
Yeah. So you made a good winter jumper out of it.
I've told people you did so many different things to make it unorthodox
and
things.
My daughter coming crying, I had those curtains up there. I'd snatch them down and make her some jeans. So the outfit, they had the little wide leg pants. Where'd you go? Wide leg pants.
You're making clothes out of the curtains.
Mm-hmm. Now snatch your kitchen curtain down. Make them.
What would you do for curtains, kitchen curtains? You just took the sheets?
Yeah, I just put the other half high up there.
I used to take the sheets. I did what you told me. You told me a couple of times, don't buy no dang curtains. Buy the sheets and make your own curtains.
Yeah, that's they can put to him. You're not the big him.
Yeah.
It gets us anyway if you bought them. I bought 20 yards or 30 yards of cloth. I had to pay 50 cents a week on it. And my brother got it out for me. And I made my curtain for my kitchen, for my living room. And the people was mad at me because they say decorator make them.
Oh, okay.
I told them, no, I had made them with the broom handle. I didn't even have a tape.
Oh, Grandma. I appreciate it. Basically, the advice is forget about the man. It happens and just keep on going.
Hey, look, they ain't going to help. What do you want with them?
A couple of my friends, they don't even have no children. They just struggling with trying to keep coping because they've been in different relationships and things. A friend of mine wrote a book called...
If he don't want you, you can't make him want you. Now, a woman came to my house and told me, Calvin Harris, I went out with him and I left my slip in his car, in my pants. He said his mother was pregnant and come and ask you for them. Doing well. Yeah, you slip in your things. Mm-hmm. Tell them that I'm not exactly his mother. I'm Mrs. The mother of two children. So then they offer me to come fight. I told them, I want to fight. I went down and I told the lady, you want to fight me? She said, yeah. I want to let you know Calvin is mine. I said, well, why don't you take him? Because the one thing about it, he don't like you and he don't like me.
Go ahead and have him. You'll make it.
Hey, I turn right around and walk away. This is cute. Look. This is what I told you. See this lady?
Mm-hmm.
And that little boy?
Yeah.
Well, she came and sat down to the table and ate and laughed with us and had a lot of
fun. Oh, that's the one I told her. Yeah, now I remember. I remember that boy. That's the boy I smacked his hands because he took
no,
the...
No, this one is not. This is in Kingsbury.
This looks like the kid I hit because he took the candy.
Well... This is a new lady. It might look like her. But this woman, nobody invited her.
Mm.
She ate and laughed with us and then got up and thanked us for the food and left. It was Thanksgiving Day.
And we didn't know him, but you just brought him over to have food.
And we didn't bring her. She came in and she knocked, rang the doorbell. We let her in. So we thought that it was Roy's girlfriend.
And it wasn't.
No, Roy said, I don't know.
So we know somebody's got a good for Thanksgiving meal. I don't know.
No, I said it was welcome. Could have been Angel. Who knows?
You know, it wasn't Uncle Roy's girlfriend.
No.
And nobody knew it was him, but we loved him and brought him in anyway.
Yeah, we welcomed him in and fed him and everything.
And that's the other pictures of him.
Yeah, that could be. I said, that's me right there. Getting ready to go to church.
That, you know, that's one of those stories that's just like, God bless you. I remember that blanket.
Yeah, Jerome took it to Arizona with it.
But see, that's one of those blessed stories that you can tell that, you know, that's just like, you give this gift. That's just how the gift, because you fed everybody.
This is true. I had all my family there. And there really wasn't plates around the table. Some of them were sitting all over.
Why are people so... I know we live in a different time. And so it may be a question. I already know the answer. But why are people so scared just to help feed another person these days? And so
I don't know. I think it's wonderful. I was... I had a dinner. I came from church in Belma and... Was it Grady? Anyway, we come to church and the Bradshaws, everybody came to say... No, they came behind us, and we were sitting at the table there and everything, and they all sat down and ate and everything.
Because, you know, and the people just don't bother want to feed anybody no more and take care of everybody. It's just that we live in a society that just don't want to take care of people one another first.
Well, that's no way to do.
You told me never let nobody starve.
No, you don't remember her. She was a good friend.
I remember the face.
That's all... oh, Lordy, I forgot her name. Thomasina. That's Mildred's daughter.
Mm. Well, so tell the women that's going through these things, just tell them to just keep on trucking.
Look at this. Yeah, tell them, look, you don't want to take care of your baby? Okay, I'm not going to call it your baby no more. It's my baby. So, take a walk.
Mm. Or if they don't have a baby with the person, just leave them.
Leave them. Go on. Leave. Hey, if you ain't got nobody, you'd be crazy to stay with them. You got to be kidding. I've been going so long, you didn't know what way I went.
And that never stopped you from dealing with anybody?
No.
Grandma, you did a lot of bad things.
Yeah, I said I did. I said, I have to pray to ask the Lord to forgive me. Isn't that a nice picture?
Yes, that's mom.
She graduated from Raiden from Trenton High. In the 12th grade.
I remember that. Yeah. Now,
this is when the disease started to set in.
I remember.
Stephanie.
What about, how could you never date the cab driver?
Oh, I dated him.
Well, let me rephrase that. I know you dated him, but how come he never stayed?
Because, you know what he told me? I came one day, he was in the bed, and so he said to me, make me some, he called me, told me, Neil, to come over and make me some salmon cake. I worked all night working 11 to 7. So
well, I remember he stayed. Okay, I remember one night he stayed. I know a few nights he stayed with me. He drove the cab all day. He would come, he would get off at his shift enough time to take you to work.
Yeah.
And then take you to work.
Go on and take me to work.
Yeah. And then he would always come back in. And then a couple few nights he stayed with me.
Yeah, called me and told me, could he stay tonight? I said, yeah, why?
Because he was tired. Because I remember you told me you had some food for him. Mm-hmm. You told me to be nice to him. Mm-hmm. I know sometimes I wasn't.
You know what happened? I came, it was raining. And I had just got paid. And so I went to, I stopped by his house to make the salmon cake.
Mm-hmm.
And he said to me, he told his friend, say, he had another man living there with him. He said, I got me a woman at work, and boy, is she going to give me some money. I said, yeah, you sit with them, wait for it. So he said, you ain't going to give me no money, no. So he said to me, what if I get up and knock you out? I said, I tell you what, don't look back, don't look behind you, don't look ahead of you, don't look on the side, because I'm coming at you. I bet you he never tried that
no. No, he never. That's the thing. He was not abusive. He was always nice. Well, then again, he dealt with
well,
you.
Well, you talk about. Yeah. He might have beat him up. I don't know. This is the same dinner table before everybody got there.
I remember, because he would get up in the morning and then I wouldn't see him because he would drop you off and then he'll go back to work. He drove the cab from like he picked you up at 6.
Yeah.
And then he drove from 7 to, he worked 12 hours, 7 to 7 every day.
Yeah, they would work all the time. They was making good money. Cab driving make good money. Yeah.
I remember.
Especially in the city.
I remember that. But why you never stayed with him? Or in fact, I know he died.
Yeah, he died. Maybe he was drunk. I don't know what he did. Because I told him, I said, look, I say.
He never drank. I respect him for that. I knew he drank, but he never would drink in the house and he never would drink with me.
He said, I told him, I said, Oscar, I'm leaving. I'm going to Axton, Virginia. He said to me, oh, no, you can't go leave me. I said, look. I said, you got a lot of women around here. You don't want me.
Oscar been around for like 20-something years.
I think he was born there. He said, no, you ain't going to just say that. So when I left, he said he used to go sit in front of the house and cry. So I used to cook a big pot of food for him and give it to him. He'd take it home. Look.
He had nobody. He cooked, my grandma, you cooked for the man for 20 years. I mean.
He did.
You had other men and you still cooked for Oscar. Well, then again, you felt bad for him because he had nowhere else to. He had nobody. Where did Oscar live? I never thought he even.
On Western Avenue.
I never thought he even. I know as a kid, I always said he never had a house. He lived in a taxi. Mm. Like, he never had. He worked every day for his life. I don't remember the man ever taking a vacation. When you took a vacation, he never did.
When Oscar retired from the cab, he just drove a little while and then quit before I left. He got food stamps and he was on Social Security.
But he didn't need Social Security. That man had loaded money. Yeah, he just put money. All his money. He put all his money away.
Mm-hmm.
I told him why he didn't go on vacation. I remember before I was in college. I asked him why he didn't just go on vacation somewhere.
Hey, old Bobby wouldn't like that, would he?
What?
That was my best friend there. She died before I left.
I don't remember.
You remember Dorothy?
Yes, I remember Dorothy.
She lived on the third floor.
Mm-hmm.
She used to keep you when I couldn't.
I remember.
That's Sam.
I remember Sam.
That's Rosalyn's husband, Sammy Ruff.
Mm-hmm. What would,
you don't want to see that. That's Grandpa.
No, I remember Grandma.
That's Roy. That's Roy's girl.
If you could have your own business back now, Grandma, or if you had a business back then, what would that business be?
That'd be a haberdash.
A haberdash?
Yeah, when I sell a little bit of everything. You know, women clothes and bows and hair pieces and everything.
Just like a woman's clothing store.
Men, yeah. Well, it could be men too, because I could sell ties and tie pins.
So you just have a little stuff around.
Yeah, because okay. Call it having that store, you have. Well, you gotta have something. You need a bow tie, you can come right down and get one.
You taught me at an early age that it was always important to have our own business.
Yeah, it's good because you don't have to answer to nobody but yourself. Nah, if you play out your money, that's your money. Right?
Yeah. Okay. I didn't make enough to play out my own money, Grandma.
You wanna keep your business intact? You're gonna have to put some of it in the bank.
I remember you said
that was something called a rainy day.
And then you said, you told me, I won't use the language you told me, but you said, your stuff is no good gold and a woman's stuff is no gold, so don't act like it.
That's right. All the same, no matter how you do. So you better remember that. The best thing to do, if she got 2-3 kids, then you begin to like it, run like the devil.
Grandma, there's a lot of women with kids these days, Grandma. They all not bad.
I know they ain't all bad, but they ain't yours either. And if she finds somebody with a lot of money, she's going to leave you and you're going to be hurt.
Well, no, they're not. Grandma, I've known a lot of good women with multiple kids. Unfortunately, a lot of these dumb guys leave them and stuff like that or whatever. And then sometimes it's the woman's, it takes two to tango. It's not always.
Well, you're going to have to be on one accord.
Yeah.
Because if you chastise a child and the woman don't like the way you do it, well, that's a fight there.
Well, that's where it's important to have the conversation.
That's right. That's when he got to be ahead of the accident.
Yeah.
He worked rescue mission.
Mm-hmm. You always were also one thing. You was always a part of a mission at the church.
Yeah.
The food. I think it was the food. I don't know what it was,
yeah,
but it was the food mission.
I worked in the kitchen. I worked in the kitchen. I cooked. I served.
Why did you cook for everybody in the community? I remember people used to come by and complain, "Don't feed this person. Don't feed that person." But you fed them anyway.
That's right. If you don't do that. I saw a man sit inside the fence. Yeah, I don't know how long he'd been sitting there. But I felt bad because I didn't see him when I left the house.
Mm.
When I come back, he was still there.
And you fed him.
Yeah. You don't do that.
I remember you sending me everywhere with a plate and foil and bring it to this door, bring it to that door.
Yeah. You feed those people. You got all that food.
Because I always remember you, that, you know, you take care of your community. If nothing else, nobody in the community starved.
Follow me. And the little girl, I went out to poach one morning. You know, was you with me? Yeah, you were still with me. A little girl, couldn't have been no more than about 2 years old, sitting on the poach in the snow, on the ground, barefooted, in a little nightgown.
What happened with that? I remember parts of that.
A mother was looking for her. I took her home.
How'd she get lost that far, Grandma?
Well, her mother was asleep. She worked night.
So she
and
just...
she came home. And see, you can't leave with a little child in that door right there. She would unlock that door and go out.
So she just overslept because she worked so hard.
No, she woke up and went to check to see if the little baby was there in the crib. She wasn't there. And she started to cry and look in the neighborhood looking for her. And I had her there with putting on those shoes and clothes because some of my kids' clothes because she didn't have nothing but a nightgown on and being barefoot. It was snow on the ground.
So she just walked off, being a kid.
She unlocked the door, like that door there. You don't leave that door. Because one of the kids is watching you turn that boat lock. And if they're watching you, they're going to do it too. And they're going out when you sleep because they ain't going when you're there.
I want to ask you a quick religion question, Grandma. A lot of people don't want to be associated. They love God and all that stuff, but they don't want to be associated with the title Christian because there's so many people who are Christians, but they do a lot of dirt. I keep telling them people the same thing you tell me. They're not Christians. The people, these terrorists they want to call Muslim, people always scared of Muslim. They're not Muslims. They're not Christians because they're not. Those type of, that faith does not believe in violence and the way it is and stuff like that. So they can say They can say all what they want. Why are people like to be so mean and then love to call themselves a Christian and things, and they're really not?
That's the people trying to go to heaven and straddle the fence. You heard that? Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, you can't do that. You're going to either go on one, or you're either going to stay off the fence and serve God, or you serve Him with your lips and not with your heart.
I don't think, when they say common sense, sense is not common, because people don't, you know.
No.
There's the guy in somewhere in the Midwest, Lord forgive me, he's going to jail because he was due to go to jail because the lady put his name for child support and then admitted, and it was found he was not the father. He doesn't even know anything. He never even did anything with the girl.
Well, go and tell the...
Yeah, but they were going to put him in jail anyway. I don't think he's in jail now, but they just do a lot of stuff. A guy got released by a judge, and they still won't let him out because they do a lot of different things out here down in this world.
Oh, it's quite cruel. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. The people are cruel, too. I saw a young man, he was dressed up, and he was saying that he got big money. He's going to turn in this money, and he's going to be happy. He was selling drugs for one of the senators. I said, don't, I just told him that don't, if you got arrested, don't tell him. He'll be there and get him out.
I remember the political fight I started in New Jersey when they were trying to kick all the seniors out of the complex. Yeah. And I called and cussed out the mayor and a few other people. I was ready to fight. I'm sorry. They were going to put me in jail that day, Grandma. Yeah. Because I felt it was wrong because those two guys that brought it out, I remember playing with those kids and things, and then they're going to sit there and do that to all the old people in the community out of sake of money.
No,
but you told me no, just leave it alone.
No, you got to work it out. You'll be surprised. So he did work it out, didn't he?
Yeah.
They have a whole, they tried to put me on the 7th floor. I wouldn't go. Because after you left, they say you were too old to be on my lease. So I'd give up that little house.
See, that's the thing. They should not, just because I told you, Grandma, I would come back. And to stay with you so they didn't have to make you move.
Yeah, but your mother wanted you to stay, so she wanted to put you in a private school, so there's nothing I can do.
I should have ran.
Yeah.
I should have ran.
Good. I'd have had a house.
I should have ran away. I got on that train plenty of times by myself before. I should have ran away.
Hey, I could have, would have had a house. I'd like the King's Bell. Yeah.
But
they say it's bad now. But they, you know, the part that was in the back, all that pretty green grass.
You're right.
And I'm building more houses there.
Oh, yeah, they built up all around there. But I'm going to end this video, Grandma. I've done got you here for about 2 hours recording it and things.
But, hey, it's fun.
But I'm glad you have fun, Grandma. And I thank you so much for video sitting with me and all this stuff.
Yeah, and giving you your history.
Well, I learned, so every time I learned, I did not know you went to Florida first. That's the whole thing. I did not know.
Oh, yeah, I went to Florida, yes. We must have stayed down for 6 years. You hear me say, I ain't going to Florida. I don't like it. No way. No.
I remember you telling me that, but I didn't know why.
You could dig in the ground a little bit and the water shoot right up. It's a built-up ground. That's why you hear those whole sinkholes and all the things.
Yeah. The one thing I'm always, if you told me, We lived around so many different cultures. You said the world is not going to look like you and I need to learn how to live in it.
That's right.
And I am a big support. You know, I guess the thing is I could call myself black, but we are Native American, and the other side is a Latina.
Yeah.
So technically, if I have to be technical, I guess it's Latin and Native American. But at the end of the day, we're all flowers in the field.
That's right.
And if we don't learn to get along.
You ever seen a flower fighting out there?
No.
Okay. You ever saw a grass fight?
No.
No.
So that's because that's the only way we're going to make it, because these people that's killing each other and doing all these things.
One thing about it, you must remember, you look all around you, black is beautiful. Mm-hmm. But then why the white guys going for us?
Yeah, because the thing is, because we have so many people in our family of different races and cultures that make up our families.
Yeah, because my grandma, Mamie Lee.
Say it again?
Mamie Lee, that's my father's mother. Her name was Mamie Lee.
Your grandmother.
Yeah.
So, okay, so that was Charles and Mamie.
Your great-grandmother.
Okay, that's Charlie and Mary Lee.
Mamie Lee.
Mamie Lee. Mm-hmm. How do you get a name Mamie Lee?
Well, listen to the Southern. Everybody got one of Lee or Annie Jones.
But Mamie Lee? I figure Mary Lee, but Mamie Lee?
Yeah, Mamie Lee. That's mentally you make it so bad. That's Susie Kate, Mamie Kate.
Mary Kate?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, Mary Kate, yeah. Susie Kate?
Yeah, Mamie Kate.
I know Mary Kate, but Susie Kate, I don't know.
S and May.
SMA, yeah.
And Gal, Robert Lee. Hey, look, you got Uncle James, Uncle George.
Oh, yeah.
You got relatives, you know, they're dead, but they're...
Oh, yeah, I know. I remember, I remember more than what I probably should.
Uncle Boy.
Who?
Uncle Boy, his name was Eddie Lee. He played a harmonica.
Eddie Lee, but his name was Uncle Boy.
No, we called him Uncle Boy. That was a nickname.
Okay.
His real name was Eddie Lee.
I never knew his name.
He was he could play a harp better than Muddy Waters. He was crippled. He was riding bikes.
I remember him walking. I don't remember him crippled. He played the harmonica, I remember.
Yeah, he walked. He was riding a bicycle one night coming from his girl's house. And he forgot to turn, with the curb and fell over in the lake.
Mm.
And he was being so hot, he got paralyzed.
Oh, gee. Well, Grandma, I love you very much with all my heart and everybody else out here. And I thank you so very much.
Well, I love you too, son. We're dead.
You wave everybody.
With a little hunk of love I brought home in my hand.
But I was a good boy, and I listened to everything that you said.
Yeah. Except like when you lost your teddy bear out for the bank, I had to go get it. Yeah, I bought one and paid $5.99 for a teddy bear. And that's a big amount for a bear then.
I don't know where the loss was. I thought we just lost them on a bus.
Well, what you did, you got out of the car at the bank to go behind me. And Tom, you remember Tom?
Yes.
He tried to keep you from going because there's snow going to the bank, but you went anyway with me. And when you come back, you didn't pick up the bear. And so he drove off, and nobody else looked outside. And when we got home, he said, "Where's my teddy?" We said, "We don't know." So we sent Tom to look for it, and he didn't find it. Because with all the cars around us, it ran over and mashed him down in the snow. So when the snow melted, we found him. And I had to steal him and take him to the laundromat and wash him. Because you want to keep...
Well, Grandma, I'm going to just let this go off because we're losing about time and battery. But I want to say I love you and I thank you, Grandma. You're going to wave. I'll let you wave, everybody.
You're welcome. It's good going over history. Mm-hmm. I got to get this all fixed up.
No problem. But I love you, Grandma.
Love you, too.
Bye.